are already familiar with this example. When you name a table to be joined in the from clause, you can refer to that table by an alias. Let's see how. A table alias is just an alternative table name, and you code it just near the table's name, like that. After you assign a table alias, you must use the alias in place of the original table name everywhere in the query. It's recommended to use abbreviations of the table names, which consist of just one letter or two. After you assign a table alias, you must use the alias in place of the original table name everywhere in the query. In other words, you can't use the original table name anymore. Otherwise, MySQL returns an error message. In this case, the alias shortens the name of the first names table to first n. That's not wrong and it works just fine. However, it's recommended to use abbreviations of the table names which consist of just one letter or two. Although a join condition typically consists of a single comparison, you can include two or more comparisons in a join condition using the AND and OR operators. The query in this example, for instance, uses the AND operator and adds one more condition to the AND phrase. You could use the OR operator as well. You can also join more than two tables. This select statement joins data from four tables: first names, second names, last names, and birthdays. You can think of a multi-table join as a series of two table joins proceeding from left to right. This select statement also begins to show how table aliases make a statement easier to code and read. Here, the one letter and two letter aliases that are used for the tables allow you to code the onClause more concisely. If you need a where clause and an ordered by clause, you code them to the end of the statement, as shown here. Note that the conditions specified in the where clause is applied after the condition specified in the on phrase. A self-join is a common join that joins a table to itself. The join condition in this example matches the last name column in the same table taken twice. Since in a self-join you use the same table twice, you must use aliases to distinguish one occurrence of the table from the other. In addition, the query must qualify each column name with a table alias, since every column occurs in both tables. Because a person has the same name and surname as itself, you could add a second comparison to exclude rows that match a person with itself. To do that, this condition uses the not equal operator to compare the first name columns in the two tables. Let's make some changes. We add the distinct keyword, we change the column specifications in the select clause a bit and see what happens. Doing this way, the result set contains just one single row. This is a good example of how self-joins can be very useful. This statement returns a list of those last names which are shared by at least two people. In this case, Lewis is the only surname shared by at least two people.